Hi everyone, and welcome to this review note. In this clip, we're going to be configuring Secure Shell access remotely into iOS. We're using a router rather than a switch because in Packet Tracer, 2960 switches do not allow the configuration of Secure Shell, but the routers do. So we'll be working on that instead. There's a few pieces to put in place for this, so we'll go ahead and get started. I'm already connected in with privilege mode through the console. I'm going to switch that into global config for now. One thing to be aware of for Secure Shell to work, because of the fact we're going to be generating an RSA key, we have to have a host name and domain name set. I've already got that done from the host name's perspective and the domain name on the router. We also have to have a username and password. And we have to specify that we're going to actually use that local username password model for the authentication. The way we do that is with a command, which is AAA for authentication, authorization, and accounting. And then we use the argument new model to specify that we're going to change the way that we're going to do the authentication. And once we've got that done, we can actually create a username. So the user account is going to be username. And then whatever we want the user's name to be, I'll just use my name for that. And we specify a password and a password to go with that. So that part's now configured. For Secure Shell, of course, we have to have some sort of encryption technology. We use RSA certificates or RSA signatures, I should say, in order to make that work. To do that, we need to generate an RSA key, so we'll do that next. Command is crypto key generate RSA. It's going to ask us how many bits. I'll make it 1K. Typically, these days, we use 2, 3, 4K bits to increase the level of encryption and make it harder to crack. For the demo, K bits fine. And that key is now generated. Once we've got that done, all we have to do is enable Secure Shell. We're going to use version 2 for that. So the command is IP, SSH, version, and 2. Hit enter for that. We get a message back here that says SSH has been enabled, and we're now ready to accept logins from the outside. Before we do that, though, one other thing I want to show is something we typically do. And that is not allow Telnet when we have Secure Shell. We know that Telnet is not secure because it's not encrypted. What I can do is go into those virtual lines and specify that I only want to have Secure Shell communications. So configure virtual line 0 to 4 since we're on a router. If I look at the commands available to me, the one down here at the bottom, transport, that's the one that I want. So I'm going to say transport and then input, inbound. If we look at the options that we have available to us, all none, Secure Shell, and Telnet. So none means we're not going to allow external authentication. All means both Telnet and SSH, or we can put either one in on their own. I'm going to do SSH. And we've now configured our system so that if we connect in remotely, only Secure Shell is going to work. Let's try that out. Over onto PC1, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom here. I'm going to initially start out by trying to Secure Shell in. So I'll say SSH. Dash L and my username, and then the IP of the target. Prompts me for my password. And I'm into router 1, as we can see by the prompt. Just like we see with Telnet, we can enable into the privilege mode, we can go into config mode, we can set up anything we want on the device remotely. I'm going to exit back out of here. And just to see how that transport mode works, I'm going to try to Telnet in. And we can see that we get a message back the connection to that IP was closed by the foreign host, meaning that when we tried to telnet in, our session was rejected. So all there is to setting up secure shell access for remote administration on iOS devices. It's the end of the clip. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.